I think one of the things that makes Boise State really unique in terms of snow research, one of the big ones is how accessible the mountains are. We're only 15 miles from the campus, and so we can get folks into the winter environment relatively easily. Snow impacts both Boise and Idaho because in this part of the world, our water supply comes primarily from the seasonal snow cover. About 70% of our water each year comes from the snow that falls in the mountains. And that's important both for water resources, for recreation. A lot of people use our river systems, so it's a big part of the economy, for agriculture, and then also for hydropower. And then predicting the amount of snow that we have in the mountains is important for flood forecasting as well.
We are digging a snow pit, and we dig one in the open and one in the forest. And within the snow pit, we measure the different layers of the snowpack. And then in each layer, we look at the snow crystal types, as well as the size of the snow crystals. And then we measure the density of the snow and measure the liquid water content. So we're looking at how much water is in the snowpack.
All right, first layer, 76.
As an undergraduate student, I feel honored to work on such a large project such as this, working with NASA, different universities across the Western United States, meeting and talking to other people with a little bit different backgrounds, a little bit different education systems. It really expands my knowledge and background and prepares me for the job market in the future. So yeah, I feel extremely honored.
Conducting field research is a great experience because you get to experience the different mechanisms of, like, say, snow melt and snow accumulation and see it firsthand, which is very different than when you're looking at the data inside. So you get to experience the different elements, the different parameters that affect the environment and our resources, and you get to see that firsthand.
So a LIDAR system measures the height of the snow. And this specific system, we're working with Silverhawk Aviation out of Caldwell, and it's allowing us to very quickly integrate that instrument and then fly on about 24 hours notice. What we're really finding is that the solution to the snow problem is gonna require field measurements like we're doing today, remote sensing like the helicopter that flew over today and the satellites that are timed to overpass our site, and combining the models, the remote sensing and the ground measurements. All three of those pieces are very critical. Snow is a relatively new science, and so a lot of the problems that we tackle are questions that a lot of people haven't actually looked at before. And what that means for, I think, students is that it's much easier to make an impact than in some of these other fields that have been studied for hundreds and hundreds of years.
I get to be outside for most of my job, and it was a no-brainer on my part.